Back in February, we had a chance to attend the AMD Renoir mobile platform premiere in Texas, and about 5 months later, we finally had a chance to test the first laptop based on the Ryzen 4000 series processor. It was an ultra-portable model, but a lot of you are also curious what AMD can do in a mobile gaming domain. Thankfully, now we also have a chance to check out the Lenovo Legion model based on the same platform. New Ryzen CPUs are practically dominating on desktop market, offer a better price to performance ratio than the main competitor. Lenovo Legion 5 laptop, specifically the 15ARH05 model we got to test, comes with the powerful new Ryzen 7 4800H processor that aims to challenge Intel in a mobile gaming segment that has long been an Intel's stronghold. So, let's see if Zen 2 is up to challenge performance-wise, and more importantly, how well it does in power efficiency, which had previously been one of AMD's weak points. Lenovo Legion is a well-known series of gaming gear by this company that in the laptop segment represents a fusion of modern gaming features and a ThinkPad tradition, bringing the best of both worlds. This is obvious as soon as you touch the Legion 5. Its plastic casing is coated in a polymer which feels great to touch and prevents fingerprints from staying on the surface which you will have contact with while handling the laptop daily. You also get a famous AccuType keyboard, or at least one just like it, with great key shape with a slight inward curve and some specific gaming additions like displaced cursor keys. Due to the powerful hardware inside the Legion 5, the bottom of the laptop extends at the back beyond the edge of the screen, which is something we've seen before on some gaming models. The base of the laptop is also made of plastic, and the case has probably the largest vent hole surface we've seen on any laptop so far. The cold air intake is on the bottom with two large vents blowing over the heatsink and out on the back and the sides of the case. Even though the design is not conventional, the case still has a profile that gets thinner towards the front. Most of the surface is matte black with a couple of Lenovo and Legion logos on the palm rest, bottom of the screen and screen cover, which manages to look gaming enough while staying true to the recognizable Lenovo style. Since the screen surface is not aligned with the bottom part of the laptop, its front part extends a bit above the front at the angle, which looks good but also keeps it easier to open the laptop. Two screen hinges also have small Legion logos on the sides, which is an interesting visual detail. The extended part of the back is where most of the connectors are placed, and their icons are labeled along the edge of the top side for added convenience. On the back, you'll find two large fan exhausts on the left and to the right, and between them, two USB-A 3.1 ports, one USB-C 3.1, which can be used as a DisplayPort output, a gigabit LAN port, HDMI 2.0, power connector, and Kensington lock. Power connector has a white LED status indicator and is meant to charge a huge 80 watt hour battery via a powerful 170 watt charger. Thanks to a large battery capacity, Legion 5 provides about 2.5 hours of gaming and around 9.5 hours of use if you activate the power saving mode, which is great for watching movies while traveling. Additional connectors are placed on the sides, one USB-A 3.1 on each, plus a 3.5mm audio output on the left and the reset key on the right. Left USB port also supports always-on charging, so you can connect devices to charge even when the laptop is turned off. While average 15-inch laptops are usually sized around 330 by 200mm, Legion 5 is a bit larger with 363 by 260mm, so keep that in mind since it may not fit absolutely every 15-inch laptop bag. Given the hardware that's inside and its purpose, the weight of 2.3 kilograms comes as no surprise, and it is a gaming laptop after all. Screen casing allows for a small amount of flex that does not impact the image much. IPS panel has 300 nits of brightness and anti-glare coating and reproduces colors which cover about 100% of the sRGB gamut. The 120Hz version is also available, which would be great for gaming, though it's a bit dimmer at 250 nits. Both versions come with a full HD resolution, which is okay for gaming in this size, though some users might wish for more if they intend to use the laptop as a workstation. Screen bezels are fairly thin on the sides with a thick bottom bezel and the top bezel, which also houses a 1280 by 720 pixel web camera with the signature slider mechanism, which covers the lens and hides you from any prying hacker eyes. A security feature which we've seen on most Lenovo models nowadays. The keyboard on this model looks so much like the ThinkPad AccuType keyboard, though Lenovo calls it TrueStrike on a Legion 5. A gaming DNA requires the use of RGB backlight, which has 4 light zones and few different profiles. Lenovo Vantage software is not very feature-rich though, so you can pick between the static light or breathing, wave, and color shift effects. We were somewhat disappointed with some of the effects, waves most notably, since they're not fluid, but kind of choppy, not what we would expect from a gaming laptop. Users can pick between 3 different profiles, 2 levels of brightness, and 4 different speeds if you pick the aforementioned wave effect. On the plus side, AccuType is one, if not the best, laptop keyboards, so its TrueStrike version is no different. In this case, the keys are not housed in the separate piece, but protruded through a laptop housing, which gives it an additional firmness and almost no flexing under pressure. Laptop size allows for a decent spacing between the keys, which gets more narrow in the numpad. We also like the fact that the cursor keys are slightly displaced towards the bottom. Key travel is very pleasant with about 1.5 millimeter and an actual point, which allows for precise typing with very few errors. The available space is used to its full extent, as well as the shortcuts, which are located on the function keys above the numpad on the various keys across the keyboard. Lenovo has also implemented a function plus Q combo, which allows you to choose one of 3 predefined operating modes: balance, quiet, and performance. You can tell which mode is currently active by the color of the power button in the middle above the keyboard. The blue light is quiet, balance is white, and performance is red. The default mode balances the performance and operation of the fan according to the temperature, with focus on balanced battery consumption. Quiet somewhat reduces fan performance and speed, maximizing battery savings in the process. In contrast to the quiet mode, you can only boost the performance when connected to a charger. Thanks to the slightly more aggressive cooling and the higher voltage that the CPU receives, in performance mode, the Ryzen 7 processor can maintain a slightly higher frequency for longer and thus enable better performance. For example, we tried the Cinebench R20 application in all 3 modes. In balanced mode, the CPU scored 4,405 points with a processor clock speed between 3.9 and 4 GHz. Quiet mode scores 3,587 points with an operating clock ranging between 3 and 3.5 GHz. While in performance mode, the results were 4,563 points and the processor voltage was fairly high, around 1.27 volts, and the processor clock was between 3.9 and 4.1 GHz. Of course, you can also hear the fan speeds, which makes sense since it's the performance mode after all. The bottom line is that better cooling allows the processor to keep the clock speed at higher level, allowing you better performance, which will mean a lot in apps that appreciate higher CPU frequencies. The spacious touchpad is located more towards the left, presumably due to the cursor keys, and is click pad with integrated left and right buttons, and it's based on the upper side, so the resistance will decrease as you approach the lower edge. Due to the dimensions of the keys, the touchpad is spacious and it integrates keys, allows for a larger operating surface, which means a lot for precision and using gestures. Harman Kardon speakers are located on the bottom left and right and provide high quality audio on the Legion 5. Due to the design of the cooling system, the entire bottom part of the laptop acts like one large resonant box, with sounds coming from the side openings, but also from the cooling vents, reduces the chance of you blocking the sound source on some surfaces and some positions. Although it's not the loudest we've heard, 2 speakers with 2 watts each can certainly deliver a very pleasing audio. The bass is pretty much absent, as you would expect from one laptop, so it would have been nice if Lenovo had added a subwoofer to make it even better. Gamers will probably prefer to use headphones anyway, and good news is that the combined 3.5mm jack also supports Dolby Atmos. By the way, the bottom of the chassis has large rubber bumpers, 2 smaller ones at the front and large one along the entire back side. Their role is to prevent slipping on flat surfaces, separate the housing from the surface for better cooling, and allow the surface to reflect sound. The bottom can be opened by removing a few screws, but it also requires something thin to pry it open, because there are also a few plastic hinges as an additional security. So, let's talk about perhaps the most interesting aspect, the hardware itself. GPU and CPU are cooled by two large fans and three large diameter heat pipes, one of which connects the heat sinks under both fans. Ryzen 7 4800H is undoubtedly the star of the show, with 8 physical cores and hyper-threading support, which allows for 16 simultaneous threads, something that can sure come in handy in tasks like rendering and video editing, as well as other apps which make good use of parallel processing. For other apps, you will still get a high operating frequency between 2.9 and 4.9 GHz, and an excellent cooling system makes sure those frequencies can be sustained a fair amount of time. The Ryzen 7 4800H is a member of Renoir family, a 7-nanometer Zen 2 architecture, and there's no much point in talking about the capabilities of these really great processors, as we've done it many times before in other reviews. The raw power of the processor and 16 threads allow Ryzen 7 4800H to outperform Intel Core i7-9750H and step among Intel Core i9 models such as i9-9880H. This will be good news for anyone doing 3D rendering and video editing, as it can significantly cut down the time required to complete a certain project. We should note that the maximum power consumption is fairly high at 45 watts, but that the CPU can also be very energy efficient when needed, which greatly helps with the battery life. The CPU has two slots at its disposal, each filled with 8GB of Samsung DDR4 memory at 3200MHz with tight CL22 latencies. The central element of the data storage system is the Toshiba M.2 PCIe Express SSD with a capacity of 512GB, of which after formatting, 476GB is available to the system. The performance of the data storage system is in line with expectations, which means it can achieve 2.5 gigabits per second sequential read or 1.4 gigabit per second sequential write with large data chunks. Thanks to the nature of the bus to which the SSD is connected, the number of IOPS is pretty large, enabling parallel operation with multiple data streams without waiting. All this makes for a very fluid and agile operation that even more expensive laptops would envy. The GPU system of this gaming laptop consists of two graphic chips, integrated Radeon RX Vega 7 graphics that is used for less demanding tasks, while GPU intensive applications run on the powerful NVIDIA GTX 1650 Ti GPU with 4GB of ultra-fast GDDR6 memory, which provides excellent performance, especially in newer games. Combined with full HD resolution, Legion 5 cuts through these new games like hot knife through butter. Even at very high settings and active AA options, titles like Borderlands 3, World War Z, Tomb Raider, and Far Cry 5 ran with very playable FPS limits, revealing the true nature of this laptop. The newest Borderlands game is a great example of a game which equally tasks the CPU and GPU, which can be hard for quad-core processors with mediocre operating frequencies. At 1080p and DX12 on high settings, this game can give some desktop GPUs like the RTX 2080 a run for their money, making them deliver about 80 frames per second. On this laptop, we managed to get an average FPS of 40 at high settings and 1080p, while lowering AA and anisocropic filtering gave us an extra 5 to 10 FPS needed to make the game feel more fluid. World War Z also makes good use of available CPU and GPU resources with a lot of physics calculations, and the Legion 5 is able to run it at about 72 frames per second on high settings with TAA engaged, and the FPS never went down under 60, which made for a very fluid gaming experience. We also tried Far Cry 5, a successor to a long line of gamers which we always considered very demanding. At high settings and 1080p with active TAA, Far Cry 5 ran at about 65 FPS and a minimal 57 FPS, which is a great performance for a gaming laptop. When there was no much on the screen action, the FPS would jump over 70, so the playability was really good. The built-in screen is 1080p, but if you plan to connecting the Legion 5 to a 4K monitor or a TV, you will have to make some compromises with detail level, since at that resolution, things get very demanding, very fast. During testing, we tried games in balanced and performance mode, but the difference was not that big, even though we expected it to be due to the cooling system, which looked promising. We also tried measuring the Legion 5 performance while running on battery, expecting it to switch to integrated Vega graphics, but it still tried really hard to provide necessary power to the GTX 1650 Ti and make sure that the gamers can finish their game even if they have to use the battery. The performance did drop by 20% since the battery can't really provide all the power that the charger can, so the operating frequencies got reduced a bit, but still it is very rare that a laptop can provide this level of performance on battery, so we were honestly very impressed. A behemoth 80 watt hour battery is certainly responsible for this, and as we've already mentioned, its capacity allows about 2.5 hours of gaming even when you don't have an outlet nearby. An added plus is the Rapid Charge Pro fast charging technology that allows you to recharge your battery by up to 50% in less than 30 minutes and continue just where you left off. Altogether, Lenovo Legion 5 is an all-around gaming laptop which provides very good performance for anyone looking for a new portable gaming rig. With Ryzen 7 CPU, 1650 Ti graphics, PCIe SSD, and 16GB of RAM, you're not likely to feel the lack of performance. Compared to Intel counterparts, CPU performance and battery life are not lagging behind, quite the contrary. Ryzen can trade blows with much more expensive high-class Intel chips, and all that without much impact on energy efficiency, which is paramount for a laptop. Use of the integrated Radeon graphics in GTX 1650 Ti helps balance the performance and power efficiency while allowing users to play all current games and get good gaming experience. When this is all combined with a good screen, high build quality, and a great keyboard, you likely won't mind somewhat larger overall size and choppy light effects. Legion 5 will certainly be very popular among gamers due to their affordable price for the level of performance it offers. Thank you for watching Bench House review of Lenovo Legion 5. My name is Marco, and if you want to stay tuned for more videos, feel free to hit that subscribe button, and please also like and comment on our video to support us.